plus I've still got some blood in me veins. You old bastards have forgotten how to live.
They're left here, towards Rhodes. I blame you two for rescuing them.
Far too much trouble for what we got out of it.
Yeah, takes a whole army of them.
Well, at least it ain't your job.
Ah, shut up, Arthur.
Yeah, your job's starting the fights. You ain't winning them.
We can scrap, Arthur. I'm just not good at homework.
I can see.
Besides, what do you care, Englishman? You've got no time for me. I tried to find you work, but then you're off cutting jobs with other folks, and your boy Sean doesn't get a look in.
Guess I don't want to get shot, that's all.
Yeah, you're a real fucking funny shit, Arthur Morgan, huh? Real fucking funny.
Calm down.
You better sleep with your eyes open.
Yeah, well, you're gonna sleep with your chest open if you ain't careful, boy.
I love you, Arthur Morgan. I love you. Come on, take a shot. Come on, take your best shot, please, eh?
Grow up.
And let me come on the raid with you.
Raid?
Don't be playing coy with me, son. It's unbecoming. That bloody train you and him has set up. What you're doing out here, you're going to need guns, you're going to need men.
Oh, that. So Marston told you? It ain't a big show. I need calmness. If I take you, I might as well bring Micah along.
Now compare me to that oily turd again. You're a dead man.
Fair enough.
What are you doing here, kid?
I'm coming, John, on the job.
I said you weren't coming.
Yeah, well, Arthur says I am, and it's his party, boy, so come on, let's go. Me and the big cheeses, love it. Can't wait to slit some bastard's throat.
You sure about this?
No. Are we ready?
Yeah. Train's due through tonight.
All right, then. It's on. Charles?
I'm ready.
Gentlemen, let's go earn some money.
Yep. Easy.
Hey, all the horses untethered?
Think so.
Good. They should follow on behind us.
You find a good spot, Wolfman?
Back on the road.
Yeah, follow the trail southwest. There's a spot that's remote, but should still give them enough time to spot the oil wagon.
They see this blocking the tracks, they'll stop soon enough.
except a new team of guards at the state line, so shouldn't be too much in the way of guns to deal with.
See, this is what I mean. I disappear for a couple of weeks and you cut me out of all the action.
Just the action that requires a brain.
Ha ha ha. You're a funny fella, John Marston. My folks, eh? You had your feet up the whole time, playing sick and fondling that new scar like you're gonna buy a breakfast in the morning.
They're left here, towards Rhodes. You don't know what you're talking about.
Stay close on this. Wouldn't want you getting scratched by a squirrel or something. That could put you out of commission for the rest of the year.
Why do you have to speak so much? It's incessant.
Plus, I've still got some blood in me veins. You old bastards have forgotten how to live. Slow down!
I blame you two for rescuing him.
Far too much trouble for what we got out of it.
Yeah, takes a whole army of bounty hunters to bring in Sean McGuire. And look at me now, in the Gunner Sea. Back in business, boys. You know, my dad always used to say...
Not the dad,
no,
please.
Not this again.
Fine! Damn you three! Sulky, angry, scarface. A right barrel of laughs.
Yeah.
So, you knock the tracks from the wagon, then jump them. That's the plan.
Too fast, Arthur.
Here's good. Stop the wagon over the tracks. Remember, these are innocent folks. We handle this right, nobody needs to die here.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's get it on the track. Mr. Marston, Mr. Smith, Mr. McGuire. Get over there. When she slows, order.
And you?
I'm gonna make sure she slows.
I'll do or die with you. I like it.
Get moving. Here she comes.
Make that quick and join us on there.
All right, get on that train. All yours, Captain.
Go on ahead.
Everybody stay calm and not ready to get shot. Go. Everything you got. Money, valuables.
I don't want to get robbed.
There you go.
Everything you got.
Let's make this quick, people. Come on. We ain't leaving till this passport!
Pay me what you got, mister.
I ain't got nothing.
Wanna have a little chat, Romeo and Juliet here?
Don't punish me, please.
Stop it, for pity's sake.
This is unnecessary, please.
Money, valuables.
Don't do this. Just give it to him, Thomas, please.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay. In the bag, everything you got. Keep it coming. Don't be shy.
People like you make me sick.
These two seem to think we're playing games.
Make me hurt you.
This is unnecessary. Please.
Deal with these two, will you, Mr. M?
I want to count to three. One.
Here.
Two.
Thank you.
Why do these?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery.
Empty your pockets, mister. You can be on your way. Gonna need all your money, my friend.
You sure about
that? You got a big problem.
Just show this son of a bitch we ain't playing around here. You want this fella, will you?
No. You go ahead and look for the baggage car.
Everything you got. Money.
Pay me what you got, mister.
We leave it till
you won't get hurt.
You won't get a damn stamp
from me.
Come
at you. Just look at that, baby.
Don't be shy.
Nothing else.
Everything you got.
Make me hurt you.
Don't do it. I'm begging you.
Now, take a deep breath. Give me all your money. Quick.
What did I do?
You're gonna need all your money, my friend.
Come on, Mr. Hey, Bob. We're on the clock here.
What did I do?
Getting robbed, mister. Everything you got.
Let's go, Mr. M. Let's carry.
Empty your pockets, mister, and you can be on your way.
I can handle this from here. You should check on Sean.
Okay.
None of you folks move a muscle. You hear me?
Please don't hurt me.
What is... You all right?
Deal with the baggage car.
For Christ's sake, you ain't even taking a look yet?
There's probably something in here, Arthur.
Gives you twice the chance of hitting someone.
Very funny.
Oh, I'm gonna have a ride out alone.
Arthur, we've got a problem. There's two assholes on horses.
How many you say?
I just see a pair of them.
All right, in that case, we're fighting. Marston, Smith, get ready.
You men come out the train now, do you hear? We said you men come out now.
There's only two of you, you fools. We got a whole lot less to lose. Why don't the two of you ride away? That way neither of you get killed. Goddamn liberties.
Eh? There's a few more of them turning up.
Damn my big mouth. Okay, let's deal with them.
Last chance. Drop your weapons and get off the train. Tear
them up!
Come on, pull them through the trees, you see them?
Careful, Morgan.
Shoot! You son of a bitch.
Get rid of them quick, we can make a run for it. That's how you want to do it?
This is good as it.
Now start. Behind us! We got more of the bastards riding in!
Yep.
now. I'm watching you.
After your car.
Fun, boys. Real fun. We can see what they call you as the professionals in the outfit.
Shut up.
At least we made some money. Hey, what did I get? Gotta be $100 here. Very nice.
You weren't even invited.
What now?
We still need a real big take. Enough for us to get out of here.
Was that a setup? Law turned up real fast.
I don't know. I don't think so, but I'm starting to get nervous.
Think they followed us from Blackwater?
Maybe. They found me already near Horseshoe, but I think this lot was just locals.
I hope so. I'm gonna head into Valentine, see if I can get something started there.
Good idea. Either way, we should all go it alone right now. You know the deal. Don't be followed.
Of course not, boss.
down. Okay, girl. Yep. Easy now. Thank you.
Easy there.
Oh, hey, you there. Think you could help a lady out? My horse up and died on me, twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there? Glad I ran into you. Huh. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal. Think you might have got twisted around.
Good morning.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. That fool. Always complaining, but does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the flies away, aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage for me has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit, he was a fine animal. Loyal, smart, brave. Didn't take no guff, not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by a nice warm patch. Must have dozed off, but I wake up and find some nasty piece of work pointing a rusty shotgun straight at me. Well, he gets wheezing on and I must have made some sort of noise, because the next thing I know, Biscuit had nipped his ear clean off. Kicked his hide, too, as he was hollering away. Didn't think a man could run so fast. Wait, Emerald Ranch is the other way. That's it. Let me off if you keep taking me who knows where.
Yeah. Okay, there.
Your ass backwards, you know that? I'm farther now than when I started.
Good to see you again, mister.
Liberty is worth every penny.
I never did anything wrong, but I got falsely accused, you know. Thank you for your help.
Morning to you.
Morning.
mister. Hey there, mister.
Morning to you.
Hello.
Morning. So, feeling better? How's the scar?
I heal pretty fast.
Lucky you. So you just lazing about, or you got any leads?
I got something. You see them?
Sure. Well, you see yourself as a shepherd now?
Maybe. Come on.
Well, where exactly are we going?
Collect something. Help us get some sheep.
You know, that attempt to seem all enigmatic and interesting, that might work for Dutch, but for you, it just makes you look stupid.
Come along. You'll see. That train job was a start, but we need more money. Until we can get back to Blackwater and collect.
I'm here to tell you. If we try to collect that money anytime soon, it'll come with a noose.
I was worried you'd say that. Dutch says that we...
Dutch says a lot. That's his gift. Saying things.
Oh, yeah? What do you mean by that?
I was a prize pony once. Now I'm a workhorse. Listen, Dutch is... But, well, you was at that thing in Blackwater. We already seen Pinkerton's here. New century's coming. This life, this way, well, we're the last, I reckon. We ain't long for it.
And that's the way it goes, I guess.
For me, yes.
All right.
Where are we going?
Just need to pick up something. There's a hitching post over there. Tether the horse and I'll meet you across the street. Hey!
I already don't like how this is going. Gun store.
Yep. Can you, head in, pick up a sniper rifle? I'll explain later.
Don't you wear yourself out now.
Oh, well, hello again. How can I help you today?
Looking for a rifle? Something with a sight on it.
Shouldn't be a problem. You want to see what we've got? It's all in the catalog here.
I'm gonna have to take this on credit.
Well, no, wait, we ain't even discussed terms.
Or I can take it in a way that ain't so polite.
Okay, fine, you can pay me later.
Sure.
Let's go.
Hey, move it already.
Whoa.
Why couldn't you have done that?
Done what?
Bought that gun.
I had a run-in with that fella earlier. We ain't on the best of terms.
You had a run-in. I've had a run-in with half that town.
Calm down. It's done now, ain't it?
Why are you being so cagey about all this? Always playing some goddamn game.
Me? I ain't the one taking Jack on fishing trips.
No, you ain't. If you say the boy ain't yours, what's the difference? You probably only run off again.
Why are you so interested in my life? Ain't you got one of your own?
Just do one thing or another. Not be two people at once, that's all I'm saying.
It ain't that simple. You know that as well as anyone. Same as with you and that girl. What was her name? Mary?
That was different.
No, it ain't. Just the same.
Anyway, for the love of God, will you tell me what you got me doing here before I turn around and hit the breeze?
There's a herd of sheep coming down to auction from Emerald Ranch. Folk in town were saying the owner's trying to stamp out every farm from here to Ansburg.
Yeah, I know that place.
Up there. Get a proper view. This way, Arthur. So I'm thinking that the herd will make it to auction all right, but a couple of new ranch hands will be collecting on the sale. Doubt the town will care to notice too much.
Why we need this rifle you couldn't buy yourself?
Reckon we shouldn't get too close. At least not till we know what we're dealing with. Let's see what we can see from up here. Okay, I think that's them over there.
So what now?
Put a shot in near them. I reckon they'll hightail it. They're only ranch hands. Just watch the sheep. Yep, that spooked them all right. Who are you shooting at? All right, let's go round them up. Go get the strays.
You ever work on a ranch, Marston?
No. You?
Oh, day here, there, but not much.
Most cowboys I know were dumb as trees. How hard can it be?
I guess we'll soon find out. Let's get these things. Bring them back to the yards.
Yeah! Blow up! They're pretty scattered. Let's get them all rounded up.
Easy.
Yep.
All right, we got them all. Let's head to town.
You know what? Marston, why don't you leave the sheep to me? You ride Shank, keep watch for any trouble.
I brought you in on this.
It'll be quicker this way. Trust me. This ain't the right time for you to be learning how to herd.
All right, whatever you say. I'm done arguing. Quickest route back to Valentine is right around that mountain.
Okay. Like I said, I'll handle this.
Now you got it. We're getting nowhere fast here.
Enough with the yap.
Valentine, right? Together.
Yeah.
All right. Let's get them in there and get paid. Yeah.
Who let the simpleton out of the asylum?
Hey, you need me to shut you up?
There you go.
Fine sheep.
They're okay.
Well, you seen better around here?
I've seen ones with less ambiguity about their provenance.
A lot less.
What are you trying to say?
I'm trying to say, you give me 25% kickback, and I won't say nothing to nobody.
Everything all right here?
Excuse me?
Sure, I'll excuse you for 25%.
Do you want me to put another hole in your head?
Folks swing for rustling livestock. 25%.
15.
20.
18.
Done. Calm yourself, friend. Just think of it as I'm buying your sins.
You're buying. But we're paying.
Go on now.
Come back after the auction. You'll get your money.
Dutch is waiting for us at the saloon.
He is? Thought we was doing the robbing here.
Still good money.
Damn it.
Thanks for all the help with this. Can't herd, can't swim.
Give it a rest, will ya? We ain't kids no more.
No, never really was.
Whoa!
In the end, I don't believe
after
in
you,
absolutes,
sir.
Just shades of gray. Compromises.
Compromises. Well, I have never been a man for compromising. I fear it might.
Gentlemen.
Dutch, Leopold.
Where have you been?
Working. Marston's thing.
Good. And?
We're just waiting to get some pay on a few sheep.
Leopold. My good friend, as long as you're here, why don't you and John go make sure there ain't no funny business?
Of course. Gentlemen?
Drink?
Sure.
Nothing like talking to old Strauss to make you want to blow your own brains out. I should have left him where I found him all those years ago. Bookish little Austrian, fresh off the boat, his eyes out on stalks.
Well, I guess the Dutch Vanderlyn Finishing School has some strange graduates.
That it does. To your good health.
Thank you.
Vanderlyn! Get out here! Get out here now! Vanderlyn! You don't know me, but you keep robbing me! My name is Leviticus Cornwall! I am not a man to be messed with by the likes of you! Get out here before I have these men killed!
What do you think?
Get out here, well, you depraved piece of trash!
You start spinning a yarn, when I think the moment's
you
right, I'll make a move.
You think I got where I am by letting scum like you rob from me? Vanderlyn, you're done! Now get out here now!
Deal with this nonsense.
Please, gentlemen, this is a terrible mistake. This is a case of mistaken identity. What is worse than admonishing a man for the sins of another who wants to be the Messiah? Not me. Nor do I want to be this Dutch Vanderlyn, whatever he may be. Wants to be the Messiah, not me. Nor do I want to be this Dutch Vanderlyn, whatever he may be. I am.
You're fine.
I'm not fine.
Arthur, come on. What the hell are you doing?
You make sure nobody's following us. We'll get back to camp. We're gonna gather the troops and get them to start packing up.
Sure. We can't stick around after this.
Let's go!
Right. I better get out of here.
Your time is up, you bastard!
There we go. Yep. Yep. Easy. Whoa.
easy.
I hear you saved Mr. Bell from a hanging.
I'm sorry.
Well, I suppose he'd do the same for you.
Exactly.
We're all in this together, Mr. Morgan. I know you know that.
Of course, Miss Grimshaw.
So, we keep heading east. Is that the plan?
Hello, Arthur.
For now.
And when do we stop?
Well,
when we reach Paris?
That'd be nice.
We didn't even get paid for them sheep.
We stop when we find someplace sensible. Shake them that's following us and lie low.
This is lying low? Turned into a bunch of killers. I mean it. We ain't even got the delusion of being anything but a bunch of killers.
We are just trying to survive, Hosea.
So?
We don't have a choice.
Save the silly bastard's life.
This'll end soon.
Damn right it will.
He's a grown man.
Constipated as usual.
Looks like one.
He's a goddamn father.
He's got a child. He ain't no father.
I'm just begging you.
Can't talk about this now, okay?
Suit yourself, then.
So, we moving?
Yeah. Micah told me of a place we can lie low. Look here. Dewberry Creek, he said.
Okay.
Maybe you and Charles can go take a look, clear off anyone you find before the whole lot of us move in looking so conspicuous.
And how are we gonna do that?
I don't know. Start dancing?
Looks like I turned into a goddamn errand boy.
You have turned into my son. You worry because I worry. We are just the same.
Charles, come with me. We got work to do.
Now, where have I heard that before?
Come on, girl. Whoa. Where are we going?
Find a new spot to camp. We're packing up and moving on.
Again?
We have to. Fast. We'd already pushed our luck too far before that mess we just made at Valentine.
That didn't sound good.
Killed a lot of law. Killed a lot of Cornwall's men. They must know where we are by now.
So, we're heading south?
Yeah. Area called Dewberry Creek. Dutch wants us to give it a look. Make sure it's clear and a good place to lie low for a while.
I've only known him a few months, but the way he talks, I never thought I'd see him wanting to head south.
Right. And I know by now, there ain't no lying low.
There's too many of us for that.
And there ain't no way Dutch is gonna just hide away in a cave somewhere. Goes against everything he stands for. That'd be admitting we're nothing more than low-down criminals.
Which we are.
You don't have to tell me.
So where does it end?
Where does what end?
The moving, the running.
Dutch don't see it as running.
Call it what you want.
I don't know. Before, put enough time and distance between you and the problem, eventually it went away. And this is a big country. But now, with these Pinkertons, better paid bounty hunters, I ain't so sure. Maybe the price on our heads got too big.
Yeah, they've certainly got money behind them.
They've got Cornwall's money behind them for one, which guarantees even more trouble. I think that must be it up ahead, the old dried up creek.
Seems very open.
Yeah, it does. Ain't sure to be the best in the rain, neither. Well, let's take a look around.
Hey, I see something over there. You see it? Someone on the ground there.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's been shot. Let's be careful, Arthur. There's a camp just up ahead.
Sure. Let's get ready for business.
Any issue? Shoot first, debate second.
I'm not gonna shoot for the sake of it.
Survival's for the sake of it. Quit talking.
You start. See there? Tent and a wagon. Looks deserted.
Okay, well, let's have a look around and make sure.
Where is everybody?
Maybe they heard us coming. Be careful.
I'm being careful. Someone's been here.
Sure.
Someone's still here. It's okay. It's okay. You can come out of there. You okay? You don't mean no harm.
Are you okay?
Sprechen Sie Deutsch? German?
No. Now go on. Get out of here. Go. We need the land. Go. Get the hell out of here.
They took our father.
Who did?
Men. Last night.
Where? Where did they take him?
Ain't no business of ours. I don't even speak their language.
You ain't as tough and dense as all that. Come on, Arthur. The girl was pointing this way. Let's see if we can pick up a trail.
There, girl.
There. Tracks. Come on.
I don't see nothing.
Hoof marks. This way. What's going on with you?
What do you mean?
You were just gonna send that woman and her children on their way?
We're wanted, man. We got Pinkertons breathing down our necks. We should be moving camp, not running off on some wild goose chase.
Come on, Arthur. That's not how you are.
Well, maybe you don't know me as well as you think you do.
Wait, just let me make sure this is right.
Okay, looks like they go down this way. So, what happened with those Pinkertons anyway? When you were fishing with Jack?
Said they were on to us. Offered me freedom if I turned Dutch here.
They picked the wrong man there.
We should have moved right then, if you asked me.
Think this is the right way? Give me a second.
Continues along the shore here. So like you were saying before.
Bastards told me they killed Mac. Said it right in front of Jack.
That kid. It's gonna be tough for him.
Yeah, but he has more folk looking out for him than most of the rest of us had growing up.
There we go.
John said he was going back to the auction yard to collect the money for those sheep.
He'd be a damn idiot going anywhere near that town right now.
He reckoned he'd be able to slip in and out.
Oh, well. If it's John's idea, it must be a good one.
What is it with you and him?
He disappeared on us for a while. When Jack was real young. A long while. You hear him?
He did?
Hold up. Let me check this.
Carry on along this trail. So, back to what you were saying.
And we was family, you know? Guess I still ain't fully forgiven him for that.
There's a camp up ahead.
Be careful.
Seems deserted. Let's take a look.
Where is this guy?
I don't know. But you know something? This is a better camp spot than back there. Much easier to defend.
Maybe. This looks like our feller, Charles.
Quick, cut him free and let's get out of here.
Vorsicht, Vorsicht! Das ist eine Falle, Vorsicht!
Take cover!
Three coming right at us!
What the hell do you think you're doing?
What are we doing? This ain't even our goddamn fight!
Is that all of them? Doesn't look like it.
Look out! Ryder's coming in!
Kill those sons of bitches!
Should have let them burn enough alone.
done dealt with. You get them untied, and I'll see what they've left behind for us.
Bitte, lass ihn stehen.
Come on. He looks in some pain there.
Hier drüben. Sie sind alle weg.
Let him free. Let's get him back to his family.
Machen Sie mich los. Schneiden Sie das Seil durch, bitte!
I thought you wanted to get this over with, Arthur.
It's okay. Getting you out of here.
Vielen Dank für Ihre Hilfe.
Yeah, okay. Here, you wait there a second. Charles, go find Dutch. Get the caravan to divert here. This spot should work for us.
I agree.
Take you back to your family.
Vielen Dank für Ihre Hilfe. Soll ich mitkommen? Bringen Sie mich hin.
What the hell did you do to those fellas?
Wie bitte?
Those men back there, why did they take you?
Geld. Money. Meiner Familie gehört eine Goldmine. Sie wollen Lösegeld erpressen.
How did someone even come up with them words?
Sie bringen mich zu meiner Familie? Vielen Dank. Wie haben Sie sie gefunden?
Look, I'm sorry, friend. I can barely speak English.
somehow. There they are.
Dem Herrgott sei Dank. Schatz!
Ach. Andreas! Oh. Andreas! Ich hab gedacht, du seist tot!
Beinahe wärst du gewesen, meine Lieblinge, meine Herz allerliebst. Oh, wie wunderbar. Oh.
Sie sind ein großer Mann.
Ja.
Ein großer Mann.
Ja, wirklich.
Es ist ein Segen, dass wir Sie getroffen haben.
Come on, now get out of here. This place ain't safe. Get out of here!
Ja, ja,
Famos.
Ist klar.
Famos.
Ich hab was für Sie. Einen Moment. Dankeschön. Thank you. Vielen Dank, herzlichen Dank.
Guess it was a pleasure.
Ja!
Oh, this place. Oh, it'll be perfect for us.
Hello, Arthur.
Dutch.
Miss Grimshaw, Mr. Pearson, put everyone to work. Make this place a home.
Well, I don't know where the hell we are, but we are going to make the best of it.
You okay, Sadie?
I'm no damn kitchen maid. Pearson's driving me crazy.
Well, we all gotta pitch in.
How you doing, old friend?
Fine.
It's funny, us ending up down here. My daddy died in a field in Pennsylvania, fighting this lot. I ever tell you that?
Many times.
I see I'm boring you, Arthur.
Worrying me. We lost men back there.
We have lofty goals, Arthur. We're trying to reform society to a kinder, truer, better way. Now, of course, there's gonna be casualties.
We're thieves in a world that don't want us no more.
We are dreamers in an ever duller world of facts. Now, I'll give you that, but come on. We got the day. It's nice out. Old Jose says that there's a trick around here. I reckon it's full of fit.
Hey there.
Hey, old girl, come on down here. Why don't you show us this crick you've been pissing in?
Hey, you don't look too rosy, old friend. I thought that... warmer weather would...
My days are looking good long over, Dutch.
Always dream crushing and bubble bursting, you. Come on, Hosea. Let's go fish.
All right, gentlemen. Let me show you how it's done.
Just fish here. There's a whole lake of them.
Because I need to get out for a bit. Me and the old guard. Before any of them back there, there was us.
The curious couple and their unruly son.
It feels good here. You did well finding that spot, Arthur.
More Charles than me.
It's like I can breathe again, thick and soupy as this air is. Might even do your whistling pipes some good, Hosea.
I was once in this country with Bessie. Feels like a lifetime ago.
It was a lifetime ago. But what a life we have lived. How well we have fought. Especially both of you.
I hope so.
But now, when things are desperate, we have to stick with the plan. Enough money, then find somewhere where nobody'll find us, where we don't have to hide.
Like where?
I got some ideas hatching, but I need you with me, not against me. Both of you.
Of course.
Still, we do need money, so keep a low profile, especially in the local town. After Valentine, I want everyone on best behavior here. No trouble. But start turning over the soil and the rocks. See what turns up.
Dutch, we've got to be discreet.
Imagine what a slew of rich simpletons there must be down here. Oh, this is perfect for you, Hosea. You'll be able to play them like a fiddle.
Nothing would give me greater pleasure, but...
No buts. Not today. We fish and we enjoy the day. Looks like law up ahead. Play it cool.
Easy.
Hello, gentlemen.
Well, look what the cat drug in.
I seem to have gotten myself in a spot to bother.
Quiet back there.
Let's see if we can't sort this out. How are you, boys?
Fine.
This is quite some country you have here.
We like it well enough.
Hoagie McIntosh, at your service.
Lee Gray. This is my deputy, Archibald McGregor.
It's good to meet you.
You a Scot?
Partly. The best part.
Of course.
Now, tell me, sir, what did the silly fancy fop back there do? Nothing too terrible, I trust.
He was accused of running a gold mine and investment scam.
Oh, no. I'm sure he wasn't. He is a magician. I know him. He's a fool. But he is not a bad fellow. Now, can we just...
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Shit! The Anderson boys! I can't have more scandal!
Well, allow us to help, my friend. Arthur!
Chase wanted, man.
And take Archibald with you.
Just what I signed up for. Come on, big guy.
Perhaps we can discuss the foolish magician.
Let's go after that train!
Keep your guns holstered. We need them Anderson boys alive.
Come on, hurry!
All right.
Come on, we're losing them.
Will you relax? We're not losing them.
Faster, come on. What's your name, sir?
Arthur Callahan.
Faster, Mr. Callahan, please. My neck is on the line here.
I get it. I'm doing my best. Looks like the son of a bitch is gonna make it. You sure I can't just shoot him?
No. Did I not say that?
You said plenty.
Goddamn cowards, hide behind that man!
Idiot. Now get after the others. Come on. The train is slowing down to go through the station. Now's our chance. Get to the side of the train. Get alongside that flat carriage. You think you can jump on there?
Me? Why me?
Because you ride like my grandmother.
You are something else. Come, bastards. They didn't do nothing. I think he's dead. I think I won the fight. Oh, just about.
Bring him out here.
Deputy?
Sounded like quite a commotion. Is that him?
I sincerely hope so.
Old Anders Anderson.
So what now?
Take him in. Come on. A fine job. Well done. And a pat on the back for me for stopping the train. Load Anders onto the back of your horse there, and we'll take him to Sheriff Gray. There you go. You are a natural. All right, let's take him in. Follow me.
What about the others?
Oh, we'll round them up. Anders back there is the brains of the operation, and that's really saying something.
You're the boss.
That was mighty impressive, sir, I have to admit. I'd hazard a guess you've served the law yourself at some point.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that.
Are you familiar with the area here?
No, not really.
On your right here, these tobacco fields? This is part of Caliga Hall, big estate belonging to the Gray family.
Looks bone dry.
Yes, we are in dire need of some rain round here, let me tell you. The Grays have lived in Caliga Hall for generations. Fine people. My family's been working for them for years. Sheriff Gray's the one I know best, of course, but they own half the businesses in town.
Which town?
Rhodes, sir. You don't know it? Where we're headed right now. Ain't what it was before the war, but it has its charms. I'm sure you already know of the Braithwaites.
Like I said, just got down here.
Another big family in these parts. They have an estate west of here. Awful people, truly awful. They've been fighting with the Grays for as long as I can remember.
Sounds like quite the place you got here.
Here we are. Welcome to Rhodes. Up there on your left is the Rhodes Parlor House. Very reputable saloon owned by the Gray family. We also have a general store, gunsmith, post office, train station, of course.
What more do you need?
Oh, good. They're back. And that's your friend, right?
Yep.
I saw it.
Okay, we're gonna stop just ahead on the right, outside the sheriff's office. Can you grab Anders off your horse and carry him in for me? Chop, chop. Don't just leave him slumped on there for the whole town to see. Bring him in so we can show Sheriff Gray.
Hey, fellas.
Mr. Gray! We got him.
Very good.
I told you Arthur would deliver. Man has a passion for justice.
That's wonderful.
So, about my friend here?
Your idiot friend is free to go. But no more trouble from you, partner.
I promise you, this was all just a big misunderstanding. However, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I'll pretend to appreciate that. Mr. McIntosh, it has been a real pleasure. The mostly good citizens of Rhodes, we welcome you.
Well, we're just honored to be here.
And make your friend behave. We got enough trouble from some of the residents, old-timers who've gone sadly to seed and lost their dignity.
How terrible. Come along now. I will keep this fellow on the straight and narrow.
Come back and see us sometime soon. Excuse me, gentlemen. Bo, these better be ugly rumors. Is it true you were seen talking to that wretched Penelope Braithwaite?
We can't thank you enough.
Where have you been?
Around.
And where are you staying?
I'm renting a caravan on the edge of town behind the church. It's horrible, but no one comes looking. The whole town is trapped in this interminable feud between the two families. His lot, Gray's, and Braithwaite's.
Interesting.
Two old plantation houses and falling out of rebel gold and marrying cousins or not marrying...
Arthur, that's what. Jose, you start poking around. See what you can find out about that.
I have missed you, boys. I've heard about bounty.
There's been a price on my head for 13 years. It'll take a month to find us down here, and it seems like we can have a little sport.
Well, they're good bounties.
Where you hear this?
Some fellas I met at a camp near the state line said there was talk of it in bars in the north and west for 500 miles. There was talk of super agents or some such.
Super agents? I'd love to meet one. It's just talk.
I'm sure it is. But I could not tell you.
Stay out of trouble.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Huh. Okay, so these two plants... Plantation families. Arthur, you start sniffing around the Gray's place, see what the story is there.
Yeah, I passed by it earlier with our friend, Archibald.
Good. Hosea, you see what you can find out about these Braithwaites.
All right. Thank you, Arthur.
Quite a fishing trip.
There's still time. I'm up for it.
How about you, Arthur? Have you had enough of the chase for one day?
Sure, why not?
Great. Hosea, why don't you lead us to that spot you were talking about? I kind of like this place.
Okay. Let's see if we can avoid any more excitement.
They finally broke that Mustang up again. Taking a month.
Well, damn it all.
Newspapers.
Come on.
All right, gentlemen. Follow me.
Hotter in the class today.
Miserable
hot. So how far is this creek?
It's a bit of a ride still. And it's not a creek. It's the same lake we camped on, just a different part. It'll be worth it. I saw some big drum and sturgeon there. Should be rock bass, bluegills, perch, pickerel, too. It's a good spot.
We'll see if you're as good at catching fish as you are at catching criminals, Arthur.
Trelawney owes me for that.
Trelawney owes everyone for something, but his information is good.
Plus, we are now ingratiated with the local law. I'd say it was a worthwhile diversion all around.
Spot, Hosea. Timbuktu?
Not too much farther. Anyway, you two never told me properly about that business with Cornwall in Valentine. What happened there? Apart from scaring the living daylights out of Mr. Strauss.
That was about the only upside. John and I didn't even have time to get paid for the sheep we rustled.
It is safe to say Mr. Cornwall isn't a man to let bygones be bygones.
Ambushed us in the saloon. He came with a lot of guards and what seemed like just about every lawman in the county.
We've had closer shaves, but not that many.
And if Cornwall found us, the Pinkertons couldn't have been far behind.
They found me when I was fishing with Jack, remember?
Listen, it was good we moved when we did, but that mess is behind us now.
Yes. Jack told me you were a good teacher when you took him fishing. I said he must have you confused with someone else.
Greetings, friend.
Very funny. So, you're going back to see that Sheriff Gregg?
Yeah. I don't see why not. They don't know who we are down here.
This is the spot. Down to the left there.
Coming past.
Go on! Hey now.
I saw some boats around last time. Be good to get to deeper water.
Hey. Those the boats you mean?
Yes. Good.
Behind you.
Yeah, okay.
I'm sure nobody would mind if we borrowed one of these. Come on. This looks like a fine vessel.
Okay. Come on, Arthur. Let's get her in the water.
Oh, no. I got a good feeling about fishing here. It's supposed to be some incredible sturgeon.
Oh. Okay, here we go. Let me row. You boys are too old for real labor no more.
You're too dumb for anything else.
You're still too quick for me, old man.
I enjoy picking on children. Now take us to the deeper water and pray for good luck and stupid fish.
But what about stupid luck and good fish?
That'll do, too. Keep going. I think here's good.
All right. Good luck, gentlemen. You won't catch much without a rod.
Should really come here at dawn or dusk. That's when you catch the best fish. We should use a lake lure. That'll give us a much better chance of hooking something big like a sturgeon.
What's wrong with a good old worm?
Oh, worms are
good for tiddlers like bluegill and rock bass, but you'd have to be real lucky to catch a sturgeon with one.
Lures it is, then. You heard the expert, Archer. Let's bait up.
Keep the lure moving slowly on the water so it looks like a little fish just asking to be eaten. Are you trying to make your lure look like a dead fish? They won't be interested if it ain't moving.
Got him.
I got a bite. Got one. Damn it, I lost him.
Got a nibble there, Arthur.
Arthur, you have to catch one at least.
You got a bite.
Just gotta reel him in now, Arthur. They're nibbling.
Ha! Got ya! Ah! I should have had that one.
There he is.
Something's nibbling. There we go.
Hey, look at this beauty.
There you go.
Well done, Arthur.
They can grow a lot bigger than that. Fella told me he once saw a monster lake sturgeon near the mouth of the river, just southwest of Saint Denis. 50-pounder, he reckoned.
I would like to see that. Hey, Hosea, you remember that time we sent Arthur out fishing? He came back with 3 beautiful bass.
Not this again.
I don't think I do.
Oh, yeah. You do. He was maybe 20. 21. Walked in all full of himself. We had a big feast. Toasted him all night.
This was 15 years ago.
Oh, I remember now.
Then, the next week, Arthur and I are at the market, and Fishmonger calls out, "So how did you enjoy those bass?"
Look, you can fish, or you can go drinking all day, rob someone, and buy some fish.
That's on the hook, Arthur.
I used to go fishing with this feller back in the day. Wesley, his name was. Real miserable bastard, but he loved to fish. We'd go out all the time. But one day, we were river fishing, when we see a funeral procession going over the bridge, and out of the blue, Wesley stands up, takes off his hat, bows his head. Then he sits down, picks his rod back up, and carries on. Doesn't say a word. So I'm a little surprised and say, "Wesley, that was nice of you." And he replies, "Well, felt I had to. After all, I was married to her for 30 years.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, dear God. I might swim to shore.
Remember those big salmon I caught in Montana last year? We had a banquet planned that night until Kaka went and scoffed a lot.
You never had control of that dog.
He had some spirit, though. Never lost the puppy in him, right to the end.
You know, I remember us saying how Blackwater was the furthest east we'd ever been. As a group, I mean.
Feels like the more we try to head west, the further east we end up.
We had all those safe spots picked out to lie low in New Austin after the ferry job.
I liked it there. Still open and wild the way it should be. Somehow the desert makes you feel closer to the sky.
No point us trying to get back that way anytime soon. Pinkerton's had patrols out all over tall trees and great plains we saw when we went back for Sean.
Well, look at us now, huh? It could be worse. Plans change. That's just how life goes.
Nice, you hooked him.
Did I ever tell you my mother's buried in Blackwater?
Really? She is?
Apparently so. I only found out from an uncle of mine years later. Last I knew, she was still outside Philadelphia. I left home at 15 and didn't see her again. She and I didn't always see eye to eye. I wasn't always a very obedient child.
I can only imagine.
Still, I loved her in my own way. And she me in hers. Somehow, even from the grave, she managed to have the last laugh.
You got something biting, Arthur.
You hooked him.
Not bad, Arthur. Make sure you don't forget about that and let it rot in the bag. You got a bite there, Arthur. There you go. That's a nice one.
Not worth keeping that one. Looks like you got a bite, Arthur. Nicely done, Arthur. Keeping that one, eh?
Arthur's got a bite.
Fish on the line, Arthur. Good job, Arthur. That'll grill up nice.
Hey, I reckon we call it a day, fellas.
Already?
You ain't been chasing down outlaws.
All right. Think we got a decent haul here. Pearson will be happy. Should we head back?
We could keep the boat, not too far back to camp from here.
Good idea. Could be useful.
What about the horses?
Well, they'll find their way back.
Just follow the shore south, Arthur.
That was fun.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, boys. Now, Hosea.
Yes.
How about a song?
Okay. All right, I got one for you. I asked that gal to give me some.
I asked that gal to give me some. She says, wait till the taters is done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. Threw her on the floor and I knocked off some. I wish to God I'd passed her by. I wish to God I'd passed her by. Taters got burned and so did I.
That was pretty good. But you know, what song we should be singing?
What?
Well, look at us. Three mariners.
Ah, of course.
Well, we be three poor mariners. We come from the seas. We spend our lives in jeopardy while others live at ease. Shall we? Dance this round, 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 shall we go dance this round, round, round? Me, there is a bully boy, come pledge me on this round, 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 round. We... martial men that do our states disdain. But we care for the merchant men who do our states maintain. To them we dance this round, round, round. To them we dance this round, round, round. And he that is a bully boy, come pledge me on this ground, 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 ground,
ground. Oh, bravo! Bravo! Well, you know, we should not let the folks back at camp. All right. I think we are gonna be okay. I know. I always know whenever I got you two by my side, things are gonna be just fine. This place will be good for us. For now, anyway.
I hope so.
Well, I am going to take in the view.
I'll give these fish to Pearson.
You know, I think I've heard enough of your opinions, miss.
Is that so?
Yeah. Now make yourself useful.
Arthur, Arthur, how you been? I've been real worried.
What do you want?
Don't be like that. Just a few bucks, and I'm short.
Get lost.
Well, I'll go try someone with a heart.
You do that.
You're shouting.
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
All right then.
Yeah, they left the ladies in port.
And you preferred that, did you?
Sometimes, depending on the ladies. Should I say the women? Thank you.
survived another day.
Oh, say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
You come near me, sailor, and I'll slice you up.
You put that knife down or you could be missing a hand.
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, I ain't cooking work.
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out.